So Rahul Gandhi has stoked another controversy. His US visit has triggered one controversy after the other. Amidst the statement on Sikhs and turbans and his definition of God, the latest act of the opposition leader that has provoked fury in Indian political circles is Rahul Gandhi's meeting with the US politician. Her name is Ilhan Omar. Now, Omar, remember, was a part of a delegation of the US congressman who met Rahul Gandhi. The BJP was quick to highlight just why this photo op and coming together in a frame may have been really problematic for India by citing Ilhan Omar's long history of India baiting. Let's first up tell you why she is so controversial when viewed from an Indian lens. She is currently a U.S. House of Representatives member from Minnesota, belonging to the Democratic Party. She was born in Somalia, then she comes to the U.S. This is when her family takes asylum. She is known to have taken numerous positions against the country, generally owing to her espousing an anti-Islamophobic position in her politics. She also took Canada's side in India's diplomatic face-off over Khalistani terrorist Hardeep Singh Nijjar's killing. And most importantly, she has opposed India over the abrogation of Article 370 and also about Jammu and Kashmir. She even visited POK as a part of an allegedly Park-sponsored delegation that violated India's sovereignty. She also boycotted Prime Minister Modi's address to the US Congress just about last year. First up, how the BJP has responded and what they have to say about this meeting between Ilhan Omar and Rahul Gandhi.
The neta pratipaksh bane hain jinhone kisi ghoshit Bharat virodhi sansad ke sath mulaqat karke अपने मधुर मनोभावों की अभिव्यक्ति की है। एक बहुत दुखद याद जुड़ी हुई है 11 सितंबर से 9/11, और इस समय संयोग से राहुल गांधी अमेरिका की धरती पे हैं। मैं पूरे भारतवासियों को याद दिलाना चाहता हूं कि 9/11 के जो प्राइम एक्यूज थे खालिद शेख मोहम्मद और मोहम्मद अट्टा, कोई पॉलिटिकल पार्टी दिखाइएगा जिसने उनके पक्ष में सहानुभूति का बयान जारी किया हो। पूरे अमेरिका ने और उनकी सारी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी ने फर्म रिजॉल्व किया भारत में, अगर उसके समकक्ष जो भारत की संसद पे हमला हुआ, जिसके लिए सर्वोच्च न्यायालय ने रेयर ऑफ द रेयरेस्ट क्राइम शब्द का प्रयोग किया है अपने जजमेंट में, आप जाके चेक कर सकते हैं अफजल गुरु की हैंगिंग के बारे में। 7 साल उसकी हैंगिंग रुकी रही और आज भी जम्मू कश्मीर चुनाव में कांग्रेस के मुख्य सहयोगी दल कहते हैं कि अफजल गुरु की हैंगिंग गलत थी। वो 2015 में अफजल की हैंगिंग की पहली बरसी थी और जिसका ये लोग नैतिक समर्थन कर रहे थे।
After spewing venom against Sikhs and after denigrating Indian institutions on foreign soil, now Rahul Gandhi has done the unthinkable, meeting anti-India elements like Ilhan Omar. Ilhan Omar got a resolution against India and the US Congress. Ilhan Omar has been spewing venom against India on Article 370. She visited POK, violated India's sovereignty at a time, and that too sponsored by Pakistan. She met Imran Khan and discussed Islamophobia. She routinely pervades and perpetrates Hindu phobia and Hindu hatred. She takes a position which is contrary to India's position on Jammu Kashmir and backs the Pakistani position. Why does Rahul Gandhi have to meet her? But this is nothing new. Congress, in its Modi virodh, in its BJP virodh, meets anybody and everybody, even if they are indulging in Desh virodh. This is the true face of the Congress. Not the first time that they've done this. But the question is only this, that Priyanka Chaturvedi of the Uddhav Sena had said that this Ilhan Omar is an element that one should be wary of. She had called her out. Now, Priyanka Chaturvedi, Uddhav Sena, do you support this meeting of Rahul Gandhi with Ilhan Omar? Perhaps you should elaborate. This trip of Rahul Gandhi is nothing but a trip that is designed to rally anti-India forces only and only so that Rahul Gandhi can satisfy his lust to come to power. How can you go so low where you stand with elements like Ilhan Omar?
And also remember, the Home Minister has taken on Rahul Gandhi in a blistering social media post. Amit Shah writes that making anti-national statements and standing with forces conspiring against the country is Rahul Gandhi's habit now. He also says that Rahul has often made anti-India remarks from foreign platforms, foreign soil. He has hurt the nation's security and also hurt sentiments. This, as per the Home Minister, dovetails with the Congress's own politics of causing rifts along lines of regionalism, religion and linguistic differences. Amit Shah has also warned, however, that nobody can mess with the nation's security while the BJP is in power, We have a lot of responses also that have not just come in from the BJP, but the NDA leaders who've also called out Rahul Gandhi and this perpetrated habit.
This narrative that somehow as long as the Congress is not in power, India is a bad country. This is his narrative. He has said democracy is at risk here. He's talked about EVMs. He's talked about judiciary. He's talked about media. Every one of those things that he says when he goes abroad is a lie. He is deliberately, coming to an alliance almost, whether it is an official alliance or a formal alliance or an informal understanding, with all those interests, vested interests that are around the world.
कांग्रेस के नेता राहुल गांधी जी विदेश जाकर बार बार भारत का अपमान करते हैं, हर भारतवासी को शर्मिंदगी पहुंचाते हैं। यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स ऑफ अमेरिका के उनके दौरे के जो खबरें आ रही हैं बहुत ही दुखद है, सब पर चोट पहुंचाती है। वो भारत विरोधी ताकतों को मिलते हैं। ऐसी महिला जो भारत की बार बार आलोचना करती है, मुस्लिम ब्रदरहुड की साथ खड़ी दिखती है, पाकिस्तान के साथ खड़ी दिखती है।
हु आर द पॉलिटिकल लीडर्स इन अ कंट्री हु ऑफन सीन टू बी मूविंग अराउंड विद ऑल द नोन एंटी इंडिया एलिमेंट्स अक्रॉस द ग्लोब? हु आर द पीपल? They call themselves as leaders in India and they move around with anti-India elements abroad and then speak against India. They spell out venom against the interest of India.
आदरणीय राहुल जी का विदेशी पोषित मानसिकता का जो जिन्न है वो समय समय पर विदेश जाने पर उनके अंतर मन से निकल पड़ता है। उनका चाइना प्रेम, उनका अमेरिका प्रेम, उनका अब इटली प्रेम या उनका वो स्वाभाविक प्रक्रिया है, उनके रग रग में वो व्याप्त है। और जिस प्रकार से उन्होंने चाइना की तारीफ करी है, आश्चर्य होता है कि चाइना हमसे इस समय जो हमारी ग्रोथ रेट है भारत की वो चाइना से कहीं ज्यादा है, जो हमारी ग्रोथ रेट है वो अमेरिका से कहीं ज्यादा है।
राहुल गांधी इसी लहान उम्र से मिले हैं, ये सुडानी महिला है। सुडान में जब गृह युद्ध हुआ था तो वहां से बतौर शरणार्थी अमेरिका आकर के बसी थी और ये लगातार एक तथाकथित हिंदू फोबिया के नाम पर एक कैंपेन चलाती हैं। ऑयल प्रोड्यूसिंग कंपनीज है, ओपेक कंट्रीज हैं, उन कंट्रीज के पास जाती है, उन कंट्रीज की फंडिंग लेती हैं। तो ऐसे हिंदू विरोधी और हिंदुस्तान विरोधी लोगों से, सांसदों से और संस्थाओं से राहुल गांधी विदेश की धरती पर मिलते हैं और उसके बाद जाने अनजाने भारत के मुद्दों पर, भारत के हितों के खिलाफ बयान जारी करते हैं, जिससे निश्चित तौर पर भारत के लोगों का दिल आहत होता है। कांग्रेस पार्टी के षड्यंत्र के हम खिलाफ हैं।
And Ilhan Omar has long baited India and attempted to meddle in India's affairs, whether it be over the Kashmir issue, Assam, or even on our ties with Canada. Omar is a known proponent of granting U.S. citizenship to illegal immigrants and for also speaking up against Islamophobia. Perhaps the biggest provocation was when she visited the POK in 2022. This was a visit allegedly sponsored by the Pakistan government. She'd also then had met the Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan. Her visit had drawn the ire of the Ministry of External Affairs that had accused her of violating India's territorial sovereignty. And this is exactly how New Delhi responded to that visit then.
I think Representative Ilhan Omar, Congresswoman, we have noted that she has visited a part of the Indian Union territory of Jammu and Kashmir. That is currently illegally occupied by Pakistan. Let me just say that if such a politician wishes to practice her narrow-minded and politics at home, that's her business, that may be her business. But violating our territorial integrity and sovereignty in its pursuit makes this ours. And we think the visit is condemnable.
We also have our colleague Pragya joining us live to help us understand where is the story moving politically. You know, Pragya, the Congress continues to defend that visit, defend everything that Rahul has said so far, and even defend this picture. But are they defending the indefensible right now? Because, you know, it's not just the BJP, but the larger sentiment is that why should the LOP be seen meeting someone who's always and always spoken against the country?
Well, Deepti, you know, the problem here is not Ilhan Omar. The problem here is that LOP in the Indian Parliament, Mr. Rahul Gandhi has met someone like Ilhan Omar, a person who stands for anti-India sentiment, a person who has stoked controversies and also violated the territorial integrity and sovereignty of the country by visiting Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. The intent of Ilhan Omar is very clear. And whenever someone comes to meet a VIP like Rahul Gandhi, there is a, you know, security check. There are also the credentials that are checked. And in fact, it seems that Rahul Gandhi has okayed it if, you know, now that he has met her. It means that he wanted to meet people like Ilhan Omar while on the U.S. soil. And what do these people stand for? These people do not stand against just Narendra Modi. They stand for anti-India forces. And if Rahul Gandhi is meeting anti-India forces, obviously BJP and central government has every reason to question the intent of Mr. Rahul Gandhi also. While on one hand, Rahul Gandhi says that I had done that Bharat Jodo Yatra, I have gone to the people and, you know, actually felt the pain of the people. I want to work for India. I want to work for the downtrodden. But the sentiment that he is showing abroad is juxtaposed to what he says while he is in India. How can, you know, BJP is also questioning, how can he go there and say that I do not want to live in a country where 90% of the people do not have access to the resources. Now, BJP is now asking, who ruled the country for 70 years? Who are the people who, you know, ensures that these poor people will remain poor? Now BJP is giving, the figure saying that we have uplifted 25 crore people from poverty line. That is the difference between the Modi government and all the government before that. Okay. So this is the sentiment that BJP is also propagating here, also raking this up, because they need people of India to know what Rahul Gandhi is standing for and what kind of people Rahul Gandhi is meeting while being abroad. Absolutely. Now, Congress can easily defend it, saying that he wants to meet everyone. And there are also Congress people who are against it. But there are so many people in the Congress also who are pro-India. Why didn't he meet them? Why didn't those pictures didn't come up?
Lot of these questions will continue to be raised. Let's see if the Congress responds to any of those questions. For the moment, thank you for getting us the latest.
I am the future that was born 100 years ago. I am the purpose that emerged with India's independence. To be a force for business that takes India to the world and the world to India. Creating pathways of self-reliance. To stand for progress, the planet, and the people. Towards a future made perfect. And be a force creating abundance. Because independence is not a moment in history. It's a never-ending path to prosperity. Aditya Birla Group, a force for good.